Louisiana's oldest statewide nonprofit organization is hard at work restoring the state's eroding coastline by recycling a prized resource. This organization is named the Coalition to Restore Coastal Louisiana, or CRCL.
The Gulf of Mexico has lost over 85% of its reefs. In many parts of coastal Louisiana, there used to be vast reefs that were miles long. The previous staff that came before me at CRCL had a vision for ending the wasteful practice of these natural resources, these oyster shells, getting tossed into the landfill when our coast is so desperate for help. It was creating a shell deficit where more shell was being taken out of our waters than returned.
Eating raw oysters at an oyster bar in New Orleans, I mean, that's good living. It tickles me how they're more popular than they were 20 years ago. We have regular customers that aren't even from New Orleans, and as soon as they land at the airport, the taxi brings them here to get oysters. Then they go check in the hotel room.
About how many oysters do you have here in a day?
Too many.
Too many?
But an average busy day anywhere from about 1,000 to 1,200 oysters.
Oh, it's not too much different from what we would normally do. It's way better than throwing the shells away. Save the coastline.
Rebuild the oyster reef. Keep me with the job.
I was frustrated that we throw these oyster shells away. So, I mean, in 5 years, we've recycled over 600 tons of oyster shells from this one restaurant. It's nice to not be sending these shells to a landfill.
A lot of people think that you're gonna eat them, that you should put your lip down here and then kind of slurp them. But when you do that, you can get some shell fragment, you can get some dirt. So they say the best way to eat them is to go from the top.
Oh, so just straight up with it?
Yep, okay. Just go from the top and suck up and you won't get any of the shell fragment.
That's pretty good.
You're all natural.
Since 2014, we have recycled over 4,000 tons of oyster shell. The oyster reefs are busy filtering water. Each individual oyster can filter somewhere around 50 gallons of water a day. They provide a buffer and a wave break that helps protect the coastline behind them. They are great habitat for fish because they have lots of little nooks and crannies in them. Many other organisms feed on the young oysters or other organisms on the reefs, and they really contribute to the richness of our estuaries.
From restaurant tables and alleyway collection bins, the shells quickly accumulate in massive mounds at the harbor, where they cure in the sun for 6 months before being bagged by a volunteer.
Lovely folks are going to help transport back and forth. You don't have to now.
Fantastic.
Yep,
thank you.
Good. If you get to 42, it's a whole ton. You get a golden shell.
Ooh.
You go on our tongue club.
All right.
It is possible.
42, man. I'm going to get that prize.
Step one, gather the oysters. Step two, we're going to bag the oysters.
Step three is transport.
All right, step four and the final step of phase one, you gotta stack them onto some pallets. And then after that, we can initiate phase two, which is take these babies out to the ocean and dump them. Just dump them, and the rest is up to nature.
Once the oyster shell is placed along the shoreline, the oyster larvae that are already in the water column will settle onto that hard substrate. Oyster reefs can be used to assist with climate adaptation. One amazing feature about the oyster reefs is that they're self-maintaining. Unlike a completely man-made structure, the oysters build off of each other. And studies show that these reefs can, in many situations, keep up with sea level rise. Since Since the 1930s, we've lost a chunk of land about the size of the state of Delaware, you know, 1,900 square miles. Looking at projections of climate change impacts in the future, you know, we could lose double that in half the time, potentially, going forward. There's a difference. If you have a healthy marsh, then it's going to be a lot more resilient to those impacts and to that storm surge. If the marsh is weakened, if it's crisscrossed by canals that have facilitated saltwater intrusion, when you get a storm coming through, that salt water can really do much more damage than it would otherwise. It can kill a lot of vegetation and make the whole recovery process take much longer. Can we adapt the ecosystem to a slightly different version of what it is now, but one that's still very functional and useful to, you know, not only have a thriving ecosystem, but to also provide some of those protective functions that the marsh would. Our first reef was a half a mile long. So now that reef is hard at work, and our preliminary monitoring has shown that reef has reduced the erosion rate by half compared to a control site without an oyster reef in front of it. We are the only current oyster shell recycling program in the state. We are glad that there are some other programs in neighboring Gulf states and even along the eastern seaboard. We would love to see this take off and for some other funding mechanisms be in place. You know, the restaurants that work with us, they are putting their money where their mouth is. They have stepped up to really do good for the Gulf. They're doing something that they don't have to do. We're able to reconnect those restaurants in the way that they want to be connected to the Gulf now.